Hey everybody, Owen McCafferty here for the Film Photography Project, and today we're talking about Magazine 16. This is a movie film format introduced by Eastman Kodak Company about 85 years ago, in 1936, and it was reintroduced by the Film Photography Project just before Christmas of 2020, along with another magazine format called Magazine 8, which is an 8mm version. There's another video about that format. But today we're talking about the 16mm version. Most of the modern film that's made, 16mm film that's made today, is only perfed on one edge. And the magazine can only operate with double perforated 16mm film. Luckily, the FPP has been able to source a number of emulsions in 16mm double perforated film. And that's why we were able to introduce this in so many different emulsion types. The way it works is inside this magazine, it's preloaded with 50 feet of double perforated 16mm film, as I mentioned, and this is exactly what's inside this magazine. It's on a core, and we'll open one of these up and I'll show it to you, but it's on this core, and it's in the magazine, and it's preloaded. So the way it worked back in the day is you would go to your photo finisher, and you'd buy a roll of a magazine of film, you'd shoot it, take the magazine back to the photo finisher, who would refund your little deposit on the magazine, because the magazine was owned by Kodak. It's actually stamped on the sign. So you'd pay a little deposit when you bought it. That deposit was applied to the cost of processing, and the photo dealer would take this magazine, send it off to the lab, who would take the film out, process it, return the film to you on a reel, a 50-foot reel, and then this magazine would go back to Kodak, who would inspect it, make sure it's working okay, load fresh film into it, repackage it, and then send it back off in the world to be sold again. And that's actually how we do it here at the FPP. When you buy Magazine 16, just like Magazine 8, which is the 8mm version, included with the price is the cost of the film, processing, and digital scanning. So when you send the magazine back, we take it to the lab, we process it, we then scan it, we send your film and your scans to you, and then this comes back, we load it with fresh film, and then we send it out into the FPP store to be sold again. Inside the magazine itself, and I'll open up, this is an old roll of Kodachrome. This is how they would come packaged. This one expired in 1965. And when you opened up the carton, out comes the magazine. And included, of course, was a little slip on what you needed to know about shooting Kodachrome. Fortunately, you can't shoot Kodachrome anymore, and please don't shoot it. It's a waste of your time and money. But this is what you would get. It's sealed with tape and two screws, and that's really important because, as you're going to see when I open this up, the film is not on a daylight spool. So if you take the top off the magazine and expose it to light, all of your film is going to be ruined. So the magazine was never designed to be unloaded by the consumer. It was only designed to be unloaded by the lab in a dark room. Otherwise, you'd ruin your film. So inside the magazine, just as I showed you, this is where the film is wound. This is the supply of film. It's on a plastic core. It runs through these teeth, comes up, goes over in front of the, or I should say behind the pressure plate, then loops back around, runs through the same perforated the teeth, and then is wound back up on another core. And so this is why you can't open these yourself, or at least can't open them unless you're in a dark room, because if you did, you would ruin all this film because it's completely exposed to light. There's no daylight spools to protect it. As far as how the mechanism works when you're shooting, it's pretty ingenious. On the magazine, there's a built-in footage counter, which is an advantage over Super 8 and Magazine 8, because those two formats do not have a built-in footage counter. It's on the camera, and the camera is the one that's telling you how much film is left. But the magazine actually tells you how much film is left right there in its own counter. And what happens is that on the side of the magazine, you'll see that there's almost like a little shutter, and the film is behind there. So when you load the magazine into the camera, it pulls back this pin and that shutter opens to reveal the film and the perfs. So if you take the magazine out in the middle of shooting, you'll never expose a single frame of film, which is great. So you could take the magazine out, you could load it into another camera mid-roll, or you could take this film out. Let's say you have a roll of black and white reversal and you want to shoot a roll of color reversal in the middle of a shot. You could just take the magazine out of the camera and load another one in, and you never expose a single frame of film. That's one of the advantages. If you've ever loaded a Super 8 millimeter camera, it works the same way, but this is a Kodak Royal. Kodak Royal. A great camera, by the way. It's a 16 millimeter magazine camera. And the way it works is you simply unlock the film chamber. This is where the film goes. Put the magazine in. Lock the door. And you're ready to go. That's all you need to do. There's no threading. There's no other loading procedure. Obviously, you can see the footage counter through the little window there. And again, what's great about this format is, let's say I shoot 20 feet and I decide I want to change films or I want to change cameras. As soon as I take that magazine out, the shutter, the little safety mechanism, the shutter mechanism is engaged so that I don't expose any film whatsoever. As far as tips for shooting the film, it's just the same with any other 16 millimeter roll film. Obviously, you want to pay close attention to your exposure. Most of these magazine cameras that you can get on the market do not have automatic exposure. It's going to be manual, so you'll need either a handheld light meter or a phone app. But there's really nothing more to say about these magazines other than don't take the tape off, don't take the cover off, because obviously you ruin your film, and do take good care of the magazine, because we need them in good condition to be able to provide the next customer with fresh film. As I mentioned before, the FPP offers 16 millimeter magazines in color negative film, color reversal film, which comes in 100 ASA daylight speed, black and white reversal, and black and white negative. And that's really made possible because of the double perforated 16 millimeter film stocks that we have here at the FPP. If you have any questions or comments, certainly post them below, or you can get in touch with me directly. It's Owen, O-W-E-N, at filmphotographyproject.com. Or if you just want to send a note to the whole gang, you could send an email to podcast@filmphotographyproject.com. We hope that you do take the opportunity to shoot some of this film. It really is very convenient. It's great if you've never shot 16 millimeter film before and you've never threaded a camera before. This is a great way to get your experience with 16 millimeter film without breaking the bank or investing in, 100 feet of film or in a really expensive camera. These 16 millimeter magazine cameras, you can get them from all different manufacturers, and usually you can get them for under $20, which is great. And a lot of them are really nice and they're still in good working condition. Thanks so much for watching, and we hope to see you again soon.